Hello everybody. Today I am going to talk about composite materials. So let's begin. Actually, a composite material is a material system composed of a mixture or combination of two or more micro or macro constituents that differ in form and chemical composition and are essentially insoluble in each other. Most composites have two constituent materials. First one is matrix and second one is reinforcement. Now here we can see there are small particles in the material. So these small particles are the reinforcement, and these materials are the reinforcement, and this reinforcement actually holds. So these are the matrix. These materials are called the matrix, and this matrix actually holds these reinforcements. Now let's talk about fibers for reinforced plastic composite materials. Three main types of synthetic fibers are used in the United States to reinforce plastic materials, and they are: first one, glass fiber; second one is aramid fiber; and third one is carbon fiber. Glass is by far the most widely used reinforcement fiber and is the lowest in cost. Aramid and carbon fibers have higher strength and low densities and so are used in many applications, particularly aerospace, in spite of their higher cost. Now let's talk about glass fibers for reinforcing plastic resins. Glass fibers are used to reinforce plastic matrices to form structural composites and molding compounds. Glass fiber plastic composite materials have the following favorable characteristics. They have high strength to weight ratio, good dimensional stability, good resistance to heat, cold, moisture and corrosion, good electrical insulation properties, ease of fabrication, and relatively low cost. Now let's talk about carbon fibers for reinforcing plastic resins. Composite materials made by using carbon fibers for reinforcing plastic resin matrices such as epoxy are characterized by having a combination of lightweight, very high strength and high stiffness. These properties make the use of carbon fiber plastic composite materials especially attractive for aerospace application. Unfortunately, the relative high cost of the carbon fibers restricts their use in many industries such as the auto industry. Now let's talk about aramid fibers for reinforcing plastic resins. Aramid fiber is the generic name for aromatic polyamide fibers. Aramid fibers were introduced commercially in 1972 by DU Point under the trade name of Kevlar, and at present time there are two commercial types. First one is Kevlar 29 and second one is Kevlar 49. Kevlar 29 is low density, high strength aramid fiber designed for such applications as ballistic protection, ropes and cables. Kevlar 49 is characterized by a low density and high strength and modulus. The properties of Kevlar 49 make its fiber useful as reinforcement for plastics and composites for aerospace, marine, automotive and other industrial applications. Now let's talk about matrix materials for fiber reinforced plastic materials. Two of the most important matrix plastic resins for fiber reinforced plastics are unsaturated polyester and epoxy resins. The polyester resins are lower in cost but are usually not as strong as the epoxy resins. Unsaturated polyesters are widely used for matrices of fiber reinforced plastics. Applications for these materials include boathouse, building panels, and structural panels for automobile, aircraft and appliances. Epoxy resins cost more but have special advantages such as good strain properties and lower shrinkage after curing than polyester resins. Epoxy resins are commonly used as matrix materials for carbon and aramid fiber composites. Now let's talk about fiber reinforced plastic composite materials. Fiberglass reinforced plastic resins. The strength of fiberglass reinforced plastic is mainly related to the glass content of the material and the arrangement of the glass fibers. In general, the higher the weight percent glass in the composite, the stronger the reinforced plastic is. When there are parallel strands of glass, as may be the case for filament winding, the fiberglass content may be as high as 80% weight, which leads to very high strength for composite material. Now let's talk about carbon fiber reinforced epoxy resins. In carbon fiber composite materials, the fiber contribute the high tensile properties for rigidity and strength, while the matrix is a carrier for the alignment of the fiber and contributes some impact strength. Epoxy resins are by far the most commonly used matrices for carbon fibers, but other resins such as polyamides, polyphenolene sulfides or polysulfones may be used for certain applications. And finally, thank you for being with me.